Nübüvvet, hakikat arayışında peygamber ışığı.
Chairperson of the session, ladies and gentlemen, after a small presentation in the Arabic, this is a small presentation in English. The topic of the presentation is Prophets and a Strata of Society, Rasail-e-Noor Perspective. With a cursory glance at different treatises authored by Allama Nursi pertaining to the Prophet and his interaction with various strata of society, one can realize that Imam Nursi has tried to annotate the prophetic wisdom in a very rational and philosophical manner, quite appealing to the human mind. It appears from his writings on the subject under discussion that he internalized the Quranic injunctions and the whole gamut of the Prophet's traditions, digested them, and then brought to the Turkish nation in particular and the Muslim Ummah in general. It is pertinent to note that his entire deliberations rest on the personal day-to-day experiences. In fact, through his Risale-e-Noor, he gave a logical touch to different dimensions of the Prophet's interaction with different strata of society. Let's start with youth. I have confined myself in the framework of different strata of society to youth, to old age people, to women, and finally the sick men and women. Let's start with the youth, the most powerful class of the society. If he spends his youth in the light of Islamic injunctions as an obedient and faithful slave, he can enjoy his youth eternally, which will have no end. For such a pleasant life, one has to be equipped with weapons of firm belief and faith, as the life without belief or wrong belief is ineffective. It will bring pains, sorrows, and grief, for exceeding the superficial and fleeting enjoyment. Belief enlivens human beings, illuminates their life. It produces elevated spiritual pleasure and lights of existence for the spirit and heart. Hence, if somebody likes to enjoy the pleasure of life, he should equip himself with a strong belief, adorn with religious duties, and preserve it by abstaining from sins. He says, and I quote, "Through the light of belief, man raises to the highest of the high and acquires a value worthy of paradise, while through the darkness of unbelief, he descends to the lowest of the low and falls to a position fit for hell." I skip all other portions. And certainly I say, it will not be proper for a wise youth to fall prey to illicit pleasure of 5 to 10 years, for which he has to suffer years of grief and sorrows in this world, torment and harm in the intermediate realm, and the calamities of hell in the hereafter. When Badiuz Zaman Sayyid Nursi studied the hadith wherein the Prophet observed, "The best of youth are those who resemble men of mature age, while the worst men of middle age are those who resemble youths." I don't quote his references. And come to the second point, that is old age people. In the old age, man shrinks his aspirations, confines himself from all worldly concerns, and rests with his compassionate creator alone. His mercy comes to the assistance of living creations, creators on the face of the earth who seeks it. And every year fills this spring with innumerable bounties and gifts from the unseen, sending them to needy human beings for their sustenance. His mercy is in greater abundance relatively to human weakness. So in the old age, generally old people have so many rays of hopes. The first hope of the old people is the mercy from the Almighty. The second hope for the old people emanates from the kindness of the Prophet, who sacrificed his whole life for his community, and even till his last moment, his only voice was, my community, ummati, ummati. And the third raw ray of hope that emanates from the Holy Quran, which is the treasure of knowledge and all sciences and sciences that are developing in the world, are emanated from this spring of knowledge. And the last, according to this Nursi, is the life hereafter. Life hereafter, he proves with so many ample examples. I don't quote all these examples. He has given so many arguments and substantiated his point through these arguments, that here life hereafter is well established, none can deny, because it was the news was given by 1,24,000 prophets and countless saints and so many signs which are spreaded in the universe, that all are testimony to the life hereafter. The third point is women. According to Imam Nursi, God has given three faculties to all women across the world. He equipped them with three precious jewels. Number one, selfless sacrifices and compassion. Number two, sincerity. And number three, chastity. A woman in the form of mother sacrifices her life to save her child from danger. One can look after this point, that in the world the mother cares for her child so much, so she must care for her child in the life hereafter, that is eternal and this is temporal. So one has to think of the temporal, one has to think for the eternal life rather to think of a temporal life. Voice is not clear? Sincerity is also very important for a woman to maintain the family life. As a matter of fact, family life under the guise of culture and civilization has transformed into a temporary animal relationship, followed by eternal separation. This shakes the noble fabric of human society in the world at large. Any treachery or deception with eternal companion, that is husband, causes irreparable damages. It cannot be repaired. The hadith says, he quoted, Allama Nursi quoted in his book, and let me read out, follow the religion of elderly women. It shows that at the end, it will be elderly women who have powerful belief, so religious-minded people should respect their piety. For women, Allama Nursi has emphasized on various points. Number one, marriage. He emphasized for the marriage of women. Many women in the world, especially in the Muslim world, are going without marriage for so many reasons. He has given the reasons also, but I'm skipping all these reasons. Maybe unavailability of the suitable match, or for highest aspirations, or for other reasons. But marriage has to be solemnized. And unfaithful, he also emphasized on the unfaithful husband. Now, marriages are being solemnized on the basis of material choices, material options, and that lasts but for a little period. And finally, it results in the break, isolation, and final separation. Similarly, he emphasized on liking the motherhood. It is a natural desire for a woman to have a baby, but baby of a not of a general kind, but baby who can do after the death of his mother good things, so that the sawab can reach to the mother even after her death. And this is also very important point. Allama Nursi has deliberated upon the dress code of women. Though it may be very harsh to us, but one has to read out. He says, in the first instance of wisdom, that women like to veil themselves, and this desire is their innate disposition, for they are weak and delicate. Even Prophet says, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu qul li azwajika wa banatika wa nisa'il mu'minin yudnina alayhinna min jalabi bihinna. He quoted this verse of the Holy Quran in his treatise. Similarly, he talks about love and affection between man and women, mutual relationship. There is a lack of mistrust between man and women, which is growing day by day. He emphasized on this point, we have to rebuild the trust between men and women, and there must be mutual understanding. And mutual confidence is essential. In the third instance of wisdom, he talks about mutual confidence between husband and wife, and here felt respect and love. Immodest dressed and free and easier behavior destroys the mutual respect and love and spoils the confidence between them. And finally, he also quoted the hadith, marry and increase. This is a very famous hadith. He says, marry and increase. Now we are opting this family planning and so many other methods to contain the population or population explosion. But his argument is based on the famous hadith, marry and increase, means he wants baby boom. Ultimately, the last paragraph about the women, the medicine cannot cure. This is about the sickness. Now, the last point is sickness. About the sick people, he says, the remedy does not lie in the medicine. Somebody gets cured from the same medicine, but for some others, it has a reaction. Why does it happen? It means the medicine also needs to have effect from Almighty Allah. Unless it gets effect, it cannot harm nor benefit the human being. And ultimately, the logical expansion of such polemics goes to men's belief in the Creator. Allah, Allama Badiuzzaman said, Nursi offers 25 remedies to the human illness. They all spring from the Holy Quran and present an entirely different view of illness. One of the views, he says, it is sort of a cure. Sickness is not a disease, it is sort of a cure. The life has to be fruitful and productive. After yielding its fruit, the life has to depart. The times of calamities are long. The times of happiness are most brief. A life passed in illness is counted as worship for the believer, provided he does not complain about God. Similarly, he says about illness, sickness is a divine bounty. It is not a curse. It is a divine bounty and gift of Allah, because a sick man begins to think of the hereafter before others. Sickness reminds the man of his past life and the pleasure and happiness that he enjoyed, and makes him to believe. And that is why he has to work and operate much before others in this domain. And there are so many other quotations, but finally I come to the conclusion. Badiuzzaman Sayyid Nursi's writing is a replica of the sayings of the Prophet and the reproduction of the Quranic verses. He represents the Prophet's interaction with different strata of society in his personalized philosophical and rational paradigm. Like a theologian or expert of Ilmul Kalam, he provided his each and every point with day-to-day practical examples, more empirical than normative. Examples were chosen from the surroundings to make the argument more forceful and concrete. Each point, such as the instability of the worldly life, the importance of poor and rich, and their interdependence on each other, the old people and their feelings, the sick person and their depressions, the value of childhood and the mutual coordination and confidence between men and women is substantiated with ample examples from the modern society with certainty of belief in God in the center. He believed in the renewal of the belief by means of there is no God but God. Thank you, audacity and patient hearing. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
İstanbul İlim ve Kültür Vakfı.